Pele himself was, you know, he didn't know about Indian football. He was stunned, overwhelmed by the support. Chuni Goswami, PK Banerjee, Balaram. Now there's nobody anywhere near them. You know, they are a class apart. It's like talking about Messi, Ronaldo and Neymar, as far as Indian football is concerned. They became the first team to win the Durand tournament, the third oldest tournament in the world after the FA Cup in England and FA Cup in Scotland. The most, you know, prestigious tournament in India 3 years in a row. 63, 64, 65. Mohun Bagan, many people don't know, was like Yorkshire and cricket. They never recruited a foreigner. You know, till the first foreigner to play for them was Chima Okwere in 1990. The early 60s, Mohun Bagan was by far the best team in the country. They became the first team to win the Durand tournament, the third oldest tournament in the world after the FA Cup in England and FA Cup in Scotland. The most, you know, prestigious tournament in India 3 years in a row. 63, 64, 65. And, you know, they were looked up to. They were like the sort of Barcelona of India. At times, some of us felt that, you know, this monopoly should be broken. But they were fascinating to watch because they were so skillful, especially Chuni Goswami, you know, whose dribbling and body feints could match some of the best Brazilians. And that the flair with which Mohun Bagan attacked. And there was an aura about them. You see, Mohun Bagan was not just a club, it was an institution. It was because of the 1911, where I learnt about this all growing up, IFA Shield win. Mohun Bagan was the national sentiment. It was part of the nationalist movement. So there was a sort of aura of aristocracy about Mohun Bagan. Mohun Bagan, many people don't know, was like Yorkshire and cricket. They never recruited a foreigner. You know, till the first foreigner to play for them was Chima Okwere in 1990, which is another story because by then Indian strikers were on the decline. So, you know, other clubs just started taking foreign players. Mohun Bagan refused. Mohammedans had Majid, Jamshed, East Bengal had Chima, Chibuzor, Christopher. Mohun Bagan never took a foreign player. Mohun Bagan in the 1930s was the only team which had only 11 players from Bengal. Shyam Thapa, the reflexes he had in the box were absolutely amazing. I don't think any, not even Baichung Bhutia, he comes anywhere near Shyam Thapa. He was like an India rubber doll, you know. Remarkable reflexes, his back volleys, his agility. And you know, Shyam Thapa was a total utility player. Shyam was intuitive, brilliant player. Chunni, as I said, is automatically arguably the greatest player ever seen in India. Chunni Goswami, PK Banerjee, Balaram. Now, there's nobody anywhere near them. You know, they are a class apart. It's like talking about Messi, Ronaldo and Neymar, as far as Indian football is concerned. They were great players. Subroto himself, the loyalty that he has shown to Mohun Bagan. In fact, that 1980, the Durand final I referred to, where Shyam Thapa sort of played as a makeshift stopper back. Subroto was brilliant. He used to come out of the box like a Franz Beckenbauer. He could control a ball in mid-air with his instep. Never cleared wildly, dribbled past an opponent, set up attacks. Little slow, but he was an outstanding defender. Temperamental, hot-headed, but total committed to Mohun Bagan. 75 was, yes, East Bengal were at their peak. So I think it was a bad day in office for Mohun Bagan. The aftermath was very disappointing, sad. One Mohun Bagan fan committed suicide. Some of the players had to be hidden. It was absolutely remarkable. And Pele himself was, you know, he didn't know about Indian football. He was stunned, overwhelmed by the support. And it was again Habib who said, yeah, we are playing. You know, in fact, Pele patted Habib on his back. Shivaji Banerjee played very well in goal. And Mohun Bagan drew 2-2. It was a rainy ground. Pele was hesitant. He didn't play all out. But still, it was a top-class team. Mohun Bagan played very well because it was an outstanding Mohun Bagan team. Jima is arguably the best scorer, the striker, but limited player. I mean, he could bulldoze his way through. But overall, commitment is Barreto. Jose Ramirez Barreto, I mean, is practically a Bengali Brazilian. So Barreto is, although yes, Jima's hat-trick against Mahindras in 98 helped them win the first NFL title. So Jima's also been outstanding. Stephen Abrovi has been excellent, but overall, Jose Ramirez Barreto. There's been nobody, other player who I've liked a lot, who helped Mohun Bagan win their first I-League title, was Sonny Norde. Absolute magical on the left flank and totally committed. You know, Sonny Norde used to say, I'll give a bonus from my pay packet, let's win titles. East Bengal Mohun Bagan Derby is, I mean, the most looked forward to event. All types of people are involved. On a Derby match, we've had this, an East Bengal fan, father, who sadly lost his son. Cremated in the morning, came for the match in the afternoon. That wouldn't happen anywhere in the world. It's Asia's greatest match, forget India's. It's our fault we've not been able to market this match. And I think ISL has finally realized that you are sitting on a gold mine with better marketing and, you know, greater reach of social media. This match on a Sunday, 7 p.m., will have, you know, and with social media now, will have millions glued. It's by far, Indian football means Mohun Bagan versus East Bengal.